When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great direction of that important event. So they went to the place where important things happened, to King Herod, to his court. But what they found was the most important thing on earth had not happened in the most important place in the region. They were directed to a little town, Bethlehem, some part south of Jerusalem. It would be like them arriving in Belfast and being told, no, go to Liebigstadt. I mean, what important thing has happened in Liebigstadt in the last 100 years or so? So they directed to this unimportant place, and there they find, where it is least expected, in a place of humility, amongst the shepherds, amongst the beasts, within a stable, there they find the great and important and earth-shattering event, which is the birth of Christ. And this gives us a direction in ourselves. We often think God's actions are in the huge and earth-shattering events of our lives. And when those events fill us with sorrow and with pain, we often ask God why He wasn't there, why He didn't touch us, why He didn't change anything. We are actually challenged by the gospel of the three wise men to look for Jesus in the Liebigstadt of our lives, in the Bethlehem of our lives, the small and sometimes unimportant places we judge to be within our lives, and more so the humble places, maybe even the dark places. See there God constantly at work, helping us face the huge and the earth-shattering events that simply come to us as life rolls on. That we need to move beyond our expectations to find Christ, to find the fullness of God's presence in the unexpected, the humble, the small, the overlooked, and the misunderstood. Not only in our lives, but in each other's lives. For so often in our families and in our communities, we become so used to each other that there are no longer any surprises. And when there are surprises, we are completely flummoxed by them. We are floored by them. Rather, let us take the time to appreciate each other anew, to be able to look deeply in each other's lives, in the unexpected, in the hidden places, and there find Jesus constantly present and constantly at work. Another aspect of the Magi teach us about finding Jesus is that they had to move beyond the boundaries of their culture and their understanding into the culture and the understanding of Judah at that time. They had to move beyond their safe space into the unknown and then discover Jesus. And that tells us too that our search for Jesus is this continual pilgrimage beyond the self, where Jesus reveals himself in our neighbor, in someone who is not like us, in someone who might not share our values, our language, and our culture. Because just as surely as he is in the hidden places of our lives, he is also within the places that we hide from ourselves. The understanding of other people, the reaching out, those who appear strange and different to our way of understanding, or our way of being, or even to our way of integrity. The wise men moved beyond their comfort zone and moved beyond the expected to encounter Christ in the unexpected, in the humble, in the sense, in the shameful. They encountered Jesus Christ. And there they honored and acknowledged him with those gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, recognizing in that humble place the presence of a king and of a God and of a great sacrifice. Acknowledging in the places of darkness, in the places of rejection, in the places where everybody else ignores, acknowledging there the King, our God, the Lamb of God, is present. And so this sets for us a path of pilgrimage for our year ahead, as we celebrate Epiphany here at the beginning of the new year, to seek the light of Christ, to know that it is already burning brightly in some of the overlooked and misunderstood places in our own lives, the overlooked and misunderstood places within one another, and the overlooked and the misunderstood places within the world. And when we recognize that, when we recognize that presence of Christ in these places, we will be filled with that great rejoicing of which the Gospel speaks, that will allow us in turn to be a light to the world, showing that Christ is present in the unexpected and the overlooked.